Over hundreds of millions of years of the development of life on our planet, evolution has sometimes followed the most unpredictable paths. Plants and animals that lived in different geological eras had a bizarre appearance and acquired unusual adaptations. Some of them were gigantic, others were very small. Today, we will briefly talk about the most interesting facts related to prehistoric and some modern animals. Some of them have already been previously mentioned in our other videos, and viewers of our channel may hear about some of them for the first time. Subscribe to the Age of Dinosaurs channel. This will allow you to help be the first to know when new videos are released, and likes and comments under the video help distribute these videos through the platform's algorithms. Also, the activity from our viewers will also help the work of the channel creators. Together, we can make the channel more interesting to as many science lovers as possible from different countries. The main fact about extinct animals is that there were very, very many of them throughout the history of Earth. It is believed that approximately 0.01% of all existing species now live on the planet. It's worth considering that most of them died out as a result of severe global environmental disasters. These are known as great extinctions. Life on our planet originated more than 3.5 billion years ago. Until now, scientists do not have an exact explanation of the reasons for its appearance. At the moment, there are at least 7 scientifically based and completely fantastic versions. Some of them have already been experimentally confirmed. For example, as a result from the Miller-Urey experiment conducted in 1953, it was possible to obtain amino acids, one of the elements of protein, from an inorganic substance. Scientists have recreated the composition of the so-called primordial broth and atmosphere on the planet, after which they were exposed to electric current, simulating lightning strikes. Subsequently, more complex versions of this experiment made it possible to obtain other components of organic substances. Jellyfish are one of the most ancient multicellular animals on the planet. They appeared about 600 million years ago and have remained virtually unchanged since then. This name appeared thanks to Carl Linnaeus from the 18th century due to its external resemblance to a creature from ancient Greek mythology. Many of the extinct creatures were very large in size, but the largest of all animals lives on Earth at the same time as us. This is the blue whale. Its average length is 32 meters and its weight is about 200 tons. This is 40 times the mass of a modern elephant and 5 times the largest dinosaur. This dinosaur is considered to be Patagotitan, a sauropod from South America between 100 and 130 million years old. It was discovered in 2010 in Argentina. According to various estimates, its weight is estimated at 40 to 55 tons, and its length is 30 to 40 meters. Another long-necked giant, Diplodocus, had an equally long tail. It is believed that with its help, animals could protect themselves from predators. But recent studies have shown when Diplodocus's tail swung, its tip exceeded the speed of sound. Mathematical calculations showed that when the base of the tail was deflected by 9 degrees in both directions, the tip of such a whip accelerated at 1,200 kilometers per hour. And the reconstruction of the skeleton of this sauropod shows that it had a deflection angle of up to 30 degrees. In addition to the protective function, Diplodocus's tail could serve to communicate with each other and attract the opposite sex. Tyrannosaurus rex is considered the largest land predator. It lived in the United States and Canada at the end of the Cretaceous period. According to unconfirmed data, these dinosaurs could also be found in China and Russia. Their height reached 4 meters, length of 12 to 13 meters, and body weight from 6 to 9 tons. They had powerful legs and short front legs. The African relative of the T-Rex, Carnotaurus, had the smallest forelimbs of any theropod. The main weapons of these giants were their powerful jaws. The prehistoric seas also had their share of giants. The largest shark is the megalodon. Its weight, according to estimates, could range from 12 to 47 tons. These monsters grew up to about 15 meters in length. Judging by the remains found, megalodons lived in the seasoned oceans throughout the planet from approximately 2.6 to 28 million years ago. Megalodons could only compete with predatory whales, leviathans. The largest of them, the Melville leviathan, lived near the South American coast approximately 13 million years ago. This giant sperm whale grew to about 17 meters. His remains were discovered in 2008. It owes its name to the biblical monster, Leviathan, and to the author of the novel of Moby Dick, Henry Melville. Before megalodons and leviathans, the threat of the Earth's seas were toothed whales, Basilosaurus. Their remains, ranging from 34 to 40 million years ago, were found in the United States, Pakistan, Jordan, and the African continent. They grew up to about 20 meters in length and were undoubtedly the dominant marine predator of their time. Among the extinct snakes and lizards, there were also giants. Titanoboa is currently considered the largest snake in the history of the planet. Its maximum length was about 13 meters. They lived in the territory of modern Colombia almost immediately after the extinction of the dinosaurs, approximately 61 to 58 million years ago. These giant boas weighed up to 1.5 tons. The largest lizard, Megalania, lived on the Australian continent and neighboring islands from about 2.6 million to 40,000 years ago. Various scientists estimate its length from 3.5 to 5.5 and even 9 meters. The first representatives of this genus settled in Oceania even before the extinction of Megalania, and could have well have encountered similar dragons. Komodo dragons, which still live in this region, pose a great threat to people and livestock. But the coexistence of the first inhabitants of North America with giant carnivorous birds, phororacos, was quite likely. They just became extinct after the appearance of primitive hunters in these parts around 15 to 20,000 years ago. Perhaps these 3-meter flightless predators could not withstand competition with humans. About 5 million years ago, flying predators with a wingspan of up to 7 meters lived in Argentina. In honor of this country, they were named Argentavis. Since they had no natural enemies, they practically did not die at an early age and could live up to 100 years. It's believed that Argentavis simply fell on their prey from a height, crushing several small animals at once. These predators disdained carrion, and they immediately swallowed their prey whole. The largest bird in history of Earth was not phororacos or even Argentavis. Until the 13th century, New Zealand was home to 9 species of ostrich moa or Dinornis. The largest of them grew up to 3.5 meters and could weigh up to 250 kilograms. It's believed that these flightless birds were the victims of the first Maori hunters. But according to some evidence, moa ostriches were seen back here in the 18th and 19th century. Scientists still have not given up in hopes of finding miraculously surviving Dinornis. Australia and New Zealand are home to many amazing creatures. Currently, there are no large predators in the indigenous fauna of this region. Dingoes are the descendants of dogs introduced by humans. But not long ago, wolves also lived here. And they, like many animals in the region, were marsupials. This beast had nothing to do with ordinary wolves. The marsupial wolf was Australia's largest predator. The length of its body, including its tail, could exceed 180 centimeters. The last representative of this species died in 1936. Currently, the largest marsupial predator are the Tasmanian devils and the marsupial marten. In the late Pleistocene, Australia even had its own lions, although they were not cats, but 2 incisor marsupials. That is, they were closer to koalas and kangaroos than to real lions. The body length of this marsupial lion reached around 160 centimeters, at a height around 75 centimeters. They could weigh up to 160 kilograms. These predators became extinct approximately 46,000 years ago. That is, they, too, could have disappeared under the influence of the first Homo sapiens, who reached Australia around 50 to 60,000 years ago. But dwarf mammoths became extinct without any human intervention. Although this happened at a time when the pyramids were already being built in Egypt, Wrangel Island was home to an isolated population of these woolly mammoths. At the moment, they are considered the last mammoths on Earth. Dwarf mammoths became extinct approximately 45,000 years later than their continental relatives. This happened around 4,300 years ago. There were only about 300 of them living there. Another isolated group of mammoths lived on the Channel Islands off the coast of California. This happened around 12,000 years ago. Their height was only around 180 centimeters. Mammoths from Wrangel Island grew up to 2.5 meters. But bighorn deer, unlike dwarf mammoths, regularly became prey of primitive hunters. These ungulates lived throughout Europe and were also found in Asia and North Africa. With a height of about 2 meters, the span of their horns could reach 5 meters. They became extinct approximately 8,000 years ago. Moreover, most of the remains of these animals were found in the peat bogs of Ireland. For this reason, it's often called the Irish deer. Also, many finds of bones and horns were made at the sites of primitive people. But the main reason for their extinction is considered to be a decrease in the number of open spaces, and you can't really live in the forests with such horns. Human activity has led to the extinction of many different animals. Just 20 years ago, unique river dolphins were found in the Yangtze River Basin, but a scientific expedition undertaken in 2006 confirmed their complete disappearance. The Chinese river dolphin is considered the first cetacean to become completely extinct due to human causes. Now there are only 3 species of freshwater dolphins left in the world: Amazonian, La Plata, and Gangetic. We are grateful to the viewers who watched this video to the end. If you'd like to learn more about the animals mentioned here, we recommend that you pay attention to our previous episodes on the Age of the Dinosaurs channel. Some of them are entirely devoted to individual species of extinct and existing animals. Also, write down in the comments which of them you'd like to learn more about in our next videos.